Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We had two magnitude 7 earthquakes on 6 and 8 December, and we're going into detail about the planetary, specifically the lunar geometry at the time of those large earthquakes. The 7 magnitude earthquake in Yukon Territory, Canada, occurred later on the 6th, a major earthquake. And a 7.6, a really major earthquake in Hokkaido, Japan. And that's south, very much south of where the magnitude 8.8 earthquake occurred in Kamchatka in July. The Kuril Islands are in between, and there is a seismic gap. But also further south, Tokyo and the Nankai Trough, there have been no large earthquakes there for quite some time. Tokyo had the last really major earthquake in 1923. That's over 100 years ago. So I guess these areas should be on watch in the near future for potential larger seismic activity. Tokyo could have a magnitude 7 earthquake. The Nankai Trough could have 8.5. And these large earthquakes that we had in July and now just a 7.6, they definitely changed the stress distribution in the region. On the SSGI graph, we see that the lunar peaks on 4 and 5 December, that I pointed out in the 3 December update, they were followed by strong earthquakes, 5.5 and larger, two larger earthquakes, 5.5 and 5.8 on the 4th, and again, following the full moon that was in between with Mars, a 5.5 and a 5.5 double on the 5th. And then on 6, 7 and 8 December, we had critical geometry. I mentioned the lunar conjunction with Jupiter as critical. We had a magnitude 7 earthquake in Canada and a 7.6 in Japan, but also this typical temporal clustering that we see that happens with that geometry, 5.6, 5.6, and one in Vanuatu, Kuril Islands, and the and 5.8 aftershock in Canada. And then also a 5.5 South Sandwich Islands later on the 8th. So there is this temporal clustering with strong earthquakes in various locations on the planets, which is very typical to a typical seismic response to the planetary and lunar geometry. So let's have a look at that geometry that happened there from 6 to 8 December. This is very important because we recognize that geometry and can anticipate larger earthquakes when that kind of geometry happens. We see that Venus aligned with the Sun and Uranus on the 8th. It was preceded by specific lunar geometry. These are the green lines that you see, the lunar conjunction with Jupiter. Then we had a 45 degree angle with the Moon and Uranus. And at the same time, around the same time, 135 degrees with Mercury and Venus. It is a tight convergence, and when that happens, we can have a stronger earthquake, typically 6.6, 6.7 or larger. And that happened from the 6th to the 8th, and in that very time frame, we had two magnitude 7 earthquakes. This is very important information, very important to observe. And also, of course, the near exact conjunction with the Sun, Saturn and Neptune. But that in itself is not a critical conjunction. It was very close at 7 minutes from exact conjunction. On the 12th, this geometry was exact when Venus aligned on the other side of the Sun with Saturn, Neptune, the grand conjunction. And like I explained in a previous update, that geometry repeats itself exactly in only 60,000 years. It's really, really tight, really unique. And we also see that from 8 to 12 December, there were a bunch of planetary conjunctions, four of which were generated by the Mercury, Sun, Saturn, Neptune conjunction. But also Mars, Mercury and Jupiter is critical. And then Mercury, Earth and Uranus. So far, there was only a large aftershock 6.7 in Japan on the 12th. And then we look at the lunar geometry that follows on the planetary geometry, that is with Saturn and Neptune on the 12th. And there can be, like I explained in the 3 December video, there can be a larger seismic response today around the 14th, give or take one day. But the actual seismic response very much depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. Earth has its own geologic processes, the movement of the tectonic plates, but when a fault section has reached the tipping point, then this particular geometry is a key trigger. Okay, so let's have a look at what we're going to have in the coming time frame. Do we have critical geometry coming up? The convergence that we always look at, yes, on 15 and 16 in particular. First here we see the lunar geometry, the lunar peak on the 12th. So like I said, so far a 5.5 magnitude earthquake occurred, the only seismic response notable at the Red Islands. But we're going to have critical geometry on 15 and 16 December. Again, we have lunar geometry converging in semi-right angle geometry, especially with Venus, Saturn, Neptune and Mars. And that will be on 15 and 16 December. And it is preceded sort of, or converges with semi-right angle planetary geometry, also noteworthy, Mercury, Venus, Uranus on the 15th, early on the 15th. This is marked in red here on the map. On the SGI graph, and followed by Venus, Mercury, Uranus. They come in pairs because Mercury and Venus are close to the Sun, and then occasionally we have this geometry, the right angle or semi-right angle geometry with Mercury, Venus and Uranus, and that can be critical, again, depending on the stress levels in Earth's crust. That happens on the 15th and 16th, and as a result, I suspect we could see an obvious seismic increase as early as the 16th, temporal clustering of strong earthquakes, but especially on 17, around the 17th, May 17th, 18th of December, also following the lunar conjunction with Uranus. That could be a key earthquake trigger. I definitely expect stronger earthquakes, 5.5 at large earthquakes. This is the mid to high 5 magnitude, maybe low 6 magnitude. Let's see what's going to happen there. And then again, we have a new moon on the 20th, and we see two lunar peaks, more tight than on the 4th and 5th of December. This is again Venus and Mars on the other side of the Sun, and when the moon aligns with the Sun, with a full moon or a new moon, as opposition or conjunction, there is a clustering of lunar geometry, convergence of lunar peaks, and this happens on the 19th in the afternoon with Venus, and also on the 20th with Mars. And if we look at the solar system, first I see we have 14, 16 December. That is the lunar geometry with Venus, with Mars, and with Saturn, Neptune. Like I said, the 45 and 135 degrees convergence. We see that Venus, Mercury, and Jupiter are in a conjunction on the 14th, and Venus, Mercury, Uranus on the 15th. That's a 45 degree angle next to the paired Mercury, Venus, Uranus, 135 degrees. So this is a tight convergence from the 14th, late 14th, but primarily 15th and 16th of December. And there could be stronger seismic activity because of this, especially around the 17th, okay, give or take one day. And then here, that's the geometry that I discussed latest here. Earth on the other side with a new moon on the 20th, and we see Venus and Mars on this side here of the Sun, on the opposite side, and that's going to be significant in the coming weeks because Venus is moving between the Sun and Mars, and at the same time Earth is moving between the Sun and Jupiter. Now on the 3rd of January we're going to have a full moon where the moon aligns with the Sun, Venus and Mars in a very tight manner. It is a very tight convergence, and that happens on the 3rd of January. But as the planets move, like Venus between the Sun and Mars and Earth between the Sun and Jupiter, we're going to have a tight near quintuple conjunction with Mars, Venus, Sun, Earth and Jupiter around 8-9 January. This is geometry to keep in mind. So that's what we're going to have in the coming time frame. Like I said, 15-16 is critical, possibly larger seismic activity around the 17th as a result, give or take one day. And I think that's the most critical convergence, by the way, in this coming time frame. And then on 19-20th, with the tight convergence near new moon with Venus and Mars, there can also be stronger seismic activity as a result around the 21st. So be on extra alert in those days. In general, if you are in an earthquake prone area, you also should have an earthquake plan. And if we have critical days like this here, depicted by the SGI graph, be on extra alert. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.